make videos for a living, you spend money on gear. Too much money. You get good gear because you can't have it be the thing that fails on you. But you know what? Your good gear can break and fail too. It's a tool.
So the bottom part of my lens mount was moving in and out, which is really bad because when you put a lens on your camera, especially like a bigger lens, it's gonna bend the mount and eventually probably break something more than was what was already broken.
So I sent my camera to Panasonic's repair department to see how much it would cost to fix it. I was starting to worry my camera might be a goner.
Panasonic wanted almost $800 to fix this because they'd have to replace major components of my camera. I couldn't afford it, so I decided to take it apart myself and try to fix it.
About 4 days later, my camera came back in the same obnoxious box I sent it in. So if this were an electrical problem or if something was broken in a more serious way, it'd be tougher, just infeasible for me to fix it. But this was really just a mechanical problem, so I thought, since it would cost almost half the price of a new camera to fix, it'd be worth it to try and fix it myself, get the most life out of it that I can, maybe learn something and save the money for a new camera. Now, you might think it'd be nerve-wracking to take those screws out, and it totally is. But what reassured me is there might be a way that I could fix it that would be something that Panasonic couldn't do. They're gonna replace the part, it's gonna be brand new, and you know it's gonna work. And for me, this experience just highlighted one of the few downsides of this beautiful revolution of cameras getting smaller, cheaper, and better. There's not really a good way to fix them. There's no infrastructure for that. You can't buy parts, you can't buy a service manual. You're stuck with sending it back to the company to fix.
There and there, that's where this broke off. Well, I'm trying to JB weld this. Okay, so we're gonna put this.
So I test fit the parts so I knew which way they went back in, and then carefully used some alcohol to clean the ring and the case so there wouldn't be any oil. The tricky part was to put the JB weld on the ring in the case without making a mess. This took some patience. Luckily, that part where the case and the ring touch is fairly wide, and I thought this would give it enough support if I got a good weld, because it's also supported by the two mount points that aren't broken on the top. This was the big moment where things could have really gone wrong. I was fairly certain this would hold the ring, but what if I did it wrong? What if I stuck it in the wrong way and it's glued in forever? I might have been even worse off than if it was just loose. But it totally worked. You know, I can't necessarily endorse trying this, but it worked for me and I'm really happy about it. And I hope I never have to do something like this again.